Hello friends, now welcome to a new lecture series for review of gastroesophageal junction disorders. Among them, I would like to deal right now with hiatus hernia. This is a small lecture. If you feel, if you have some time and if you wanted to watch the full video, this is already uploaded. So all this notes which is present here is already written and explained clearly in the lecture hiatus hernia. If you have any problem in that lecture, if you have limited time, so then you can watch this lecture which is on hiatus hernia. So hiatus hernia is whenever the hollow viscus which is present in the abdomen enters the thorax through the diaphragm, that is called as hiatus hernia. The hiatus hernia is majorly of four types. The first type is sliding hiatus hernia, where this is the normal stomach or normal esophagus. The esophagus is attached to the diaphragm by phrenico-esophageal ligaments, which are there in green color here on either sides. So in sliding type of hernia, the lower gastroesophageal junction, which is present below in the abdomen, that is displaced upwards into the thorax. So here there is displacement of lower gastroesophageal junction. Displacement of gastroesophageal junction and a part of cardia into the thorax from the esophagus. My question is, why does this displacement occurs? This is because the phrenico-esophageal ligament which is present, which connects the esophagus to the diaphragm, that ligament weakens. So whenever there is weakening of this ligament, there is easily the cardia and the lower gastroesophageal junction enters the thorax. So now, in this sliding hernia, the phrenico-esophageal ligament will be intact. And on one side, the peritoneal fold can be seen. So generally, this hiatus hernia, that too, sliding type of hiatus hernia, is associated with reflux, that is gastroesophageal reflux disease, in almost 90% of the cases. This incidence increases with age and pregnancy and obesity. And it also increases with increase in abdominal pressure like coughing, etc. and also in supine position. So this is about sliding type of hiatus hernia. Now coming to the type 2, which is rolling type of hiatus hernia. In this, only the fundus of the stomach, that is displaced upwards into the thorax. So whenever the fundus of the stomach is displaced upwards into the thorax, this is the gastroesophageal junction. Here there will be phrenico-esophageal ligaments. So whenever this fundus is entering the thorax, it will tear the phrenico-esophageal ligament because of this pressure. This pressure will result in torning of phrenico-esophageal ligament. So if you examine, the phrenico-esophageal ligaments are present only on one side. And then this part of fundus is surrounded by the fold of peritoneum completely. Here the peritoneal covering is only on one side, but here the peritoneal covering is completely covering the herniated part. Right? Whereas the phrenico-esophageal ligament is torn, but the peritoneal fold is covering the entire part of hernia. And if you see, as days go on, there are longitudinal ulcers which are formed. These ulcers are called as Cameron's ulcer, which is really important. Cameron's ulcer. So this is rolling type of hiatus hernia. The third type of hiatus hernia is mixed, where there is displacement of gastroesophageal junction into the thorax and displacement of fundus into the thorax. This is type 3, mixed type of hiatus hernia. Type 4. In type 4, there is herniation of hollow viscus apart from stomach, like intestine, bore well into the thorax. So what are the clinical features? Generally, if you see in rolling type of hiatus hernia, the clinical features are like chest pain, abdominal pain, hiccups, early satiety, because most of the fundus is separated here. So whenever there is little space present in the stomach, so there is early feeling of fullness. So that is early satiety. Regurgitation is also seen, and postprandial bloating are seen. So these are the clinical features. So now coming to the investigations. Investigations of hiatus hernia. If you do plain X-ray, you see retrocardiac air fluid levels are seen clearly. Retrocardiac air fluid levels are seen. We can do barium meal. Barium meal clearly shows the hiatus hernia, that is herniated part of the stomach in the thorax. So barium meal is the gold standard for hiatus hernia. ECG can be done for arrhythmias, because the rolling type of hiatus hernia, in it arrhythmias are more common. 3D CT scan can be done. What is the treatment? The treatment is surgery majorly. In this, excise this sac and then you can repair the defect. Sometimes if this sac is really large and there is chance of more recurrence, then we do mesh replacement technique. So this is the surgery. It can be done either laparoscopically or open abdominal method. So what are the complications which you see for hiatus hernia? Whenever there is hiatus hernia, there is a chance that the herniated part blood supply is compromised, thus resulting in gangrene. And there is perforation of this herniated part into the mediastinum, or sometimes this may perforate into the peritoneum, causing peritonitis. Sometimes this herniated part may twist around itself, resulting in volvulus formation. So perforation into mediastinum or peritoneum or gangrene formation or volvulus are the complications which are seen in hiatus hernia. The most important thing which is associated with hiatus hernia is Saint's triad, which includes hiatus hernia, gallstones and diverticulosis. All this makes a triad which is called as Saint's triad. And the final surgery which is done for hiatus hernia is Allison's surgery, where this is the right cross of diaphragm and this is the esophagus. So in this hiatus which is present, that is the hole in the diaphragm, that is made narrow. So this is called as Allison surgery for hiatus. There is high failure rate for this surgery. So this Allison surgery for hiatus is always combined with other surgeries. In this, the hiatus which is present in the right crest of diaphragm, so that is narrowed. Okay, this is the end of the lecture of hiatus hernia. I hope you understood the topic. If you have any doubts, you can refer to the normal lecture of hiatus hernia, which is for around 35 to 40 minutes. Thank you for listening my lecture. If you have any doubts, you can comment it in the comment section. Thank you.